We receive calls from 6 counties which cover nearly 28,000 square miles. In other words, a whole lot of space to cover. On a warm June day, Defiance Canyon Raptor Rescue received a call about an injured bald eagle during a volunteer training session. Rescues vary. Sometimes we need to capture birds, and sometimes they are already caught.
It's a dog crate.
Okay.
Yeah, you want to take the dog crate.
And by the way, these are all my new volunteers that I'm
We were in training today.
Awesome. Very good. So
what better training than a new eagle?
Mm-hmm.
No, pretty, a couple hundred yards from the highway.
Yeah, so, that's not that far.
Yeah.
So, yeah.
So unclear. And then, the person.
That was smart.
Yeah.
Here we are checking to see if there is a smell of infection. But the eagle just smelled slightly fishy, which is normal eagle smell.
So I think we better move him out of here. Mm. It's going to be tricky.
Move him out of there?
Yeah.
Okay.
Yeah, it's going to be tricky, but right. You know, honestly, the easiest way to do it in these is they don't fit through the doors well, so it's easier to take all these screws apart and pull one up the top, and I'll just be ready for the plane.
Okay.
So, and grab his legs too.
Okay.
But yeah, so.
Get him down, I guess.
I don't know that we can.
Right.
I think we're going to have to do it like this.
Just like this. Okay.
Yeah. You know, so there's not a lot of space.
You want us to come like one side off of clamshell? We're
going
to have to lift the string.
You want to go in through this side?
Yeah. The only trouble is this door is going to cave in when we take it off, so you can hold on to it.
Yeah.
Yeah, just watch your fingers. I don't think it'll do anything. But
Oops.
Okay. Yeah. He's... Okay.
Yeah, he's not
going to
fly.
Yeah, he's not going to be able to fly out of there.
Do you want to just rotate that side open?
Yeah.
And we'll leave this side connected then?
Yeah, let's pull it this way. So we got the little girl, as the case may be.
Are you ready?
Yeah.
Well, you know, I think the guy put some steak in a bowl and some water overnight, so that, I don't know, that looks
like... Yeah. He's been like this from overnight.
Was it? He's been in a container overnight.
See the blood?
But I don't know if the blood could be steak blood.
I see meat.
Yeah,
no, I do too. I'm just trying to find his legs, actually.
Okay, gotcha.
More open?
Mm. Yeah,
open. Yeah, his head is covered now, so it's pretty good.
Okay.
Can you detach your eye? Hang on.
We have to swing this out. Is that one detached there?
Or do you have just one leg so far?
Can you cover his head better?
Yep.
Thank you.
Yep.
Got the other one. Okay. Let's... can somebody pull that blanket loose? Not mine, the other one?
Thank you.
The eagle's feet looked blackened.
Said he didn't feel like, he didn't think he was wrong when he was chasing him.
Just dehydration causing some problems. I see your mouth like biting me. Can somebody get me the forceps out of my little kit? Yeah, these feet are in pretty bad shape.
What are you looking at? Yeah.
They're kind of blackened, and the nails, instead of being black and shiny, are white and funky. And just the feet in general, they're not yellow, they're kind of dirty and funky, and it's hard to explain. They're just
clean,
not white, so.
What did you look for with the dehydration?
The color of the mouth. The color, you can see it's kind of pink, but the tip of the tongue is kind of whitish yellow.
Okay.
And it's and see, this bird is not struggling at all, which is really unusual, so there's something going on. Body condition. You can tell by the keel. So it's with eagles, they're really thickly feathered, but you can tell if the keel is sticking out, and this bird's is not. So that's a good sign that it was healthy recently. And now, there we go. Okay, you can open your mouth again. Yeah, there you go. If you open it enough for me to put that in there, that would be helpful.
If
somebody wants to try to open the mouth, either that, or if somebody wants to hold the feet.
Can you hold the feet for you?
Another hand. That'll work. And just keep your fingers out of the way, though.
Can they swallow pretty good on their back?
That's right. What was that?
Can they swallow pretty good on their back?
Yeah, I mean, as long as they're not on their back for a long time, it's better to have them upright, but it's just because of the hand situation here, so.
Mm-hmm.
And because eagles are really big, so it's harder to hold them in the crook of your arm. There we go. It's also good to, when you're using a big syringe like that, to move it slowly, so you can't shoot the whole thing down there at once. It's not a good idea. And that wasn't very much for a bird this size, but it's a little bit, and it's probably good for now. Let's see, eyes are reactive, that's good. Yeah, that's really good. So this bird, it's not in horrendously awful shape. But why it's sick, I don't know. Right, because it could have some disease going on that I can't see. I don't know. But so let's get it in the other container. I know you're being a really nice bird. You don't feel good, that's why.
That's a good sign.
I'm going to watch out for their feathers because it's important they don't get broken. Okay, so let's try to quiet for a minute. I just need to get you to fill out what you can on my paperwork.
Sure.
Although we could find no break in the left wing, it had an obvious droop. Upon further examination later, we found a wound on the top of the left wing. We transported the eagle to the veterinary hospital at UC Davis the next day, where they determined the eagle had been electrocuted. She also had a measurable level of lead in her blood. Recent research has shown that even low levels of lead can cause birds to be more accident-prone because it affects their movements. Raptors generally ingest lead secondhand from eating carrion. Lead bullets fragment and shot animals such as deer and squirrels. Let the news-